In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon his last and beloved messenger Muhammad, and may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all. This is the 12th part of a series entitled Discoveries from the Quran. And in this series I show, with the guidance of Allah God Almighty, the superiority of the knowledge of Allah in the last revelation people, the Quran, over the knowledge of people in all branches of knowledge, and how a believer can be the teacher of others by pondering upon the verses of the Quran. Now, among the topics of this 12th part is the topic you see on the screen, a human vision and iron, the relationship between our vision and iron. Now, this topic stems from this Quranic verse, which is verse number 22 of chapter 50 of the Quran, which reads, this is translation, "Indeed, you were heedless of this. Now Allah God has removed your covering, and your vision today is iron." So here, Allah God Almighty is telling us that on the Day of Judgment, when people are resurrected, you are put together again, you are assembled again, that your vision will be iron, your vision, and your vision today is iron. Now we need to ponder upon this Quranic statement and to see that we realize that Allah Almighty links our vision and the clarity of our vision with iron, meaning that Allah is telling us that on the Day of Judgment, when we are resurrected again, our senses, like our vision, will be 100%. The power of your vision, the clarity in what you see, will be 100%. No diseases, no illnesses. And the wisdom behind this is that on Day of Judgment, you either go to heaven or to hell. Now, if Allah bestowed His mercy upon you and you go to heaven, then when your senses are operating at 100%, this means that you will enjoy the blessings found in heaven 100%. That's at the mercy of Allah God Almighty. Because if there was a disease or illness, you would not enjoy the taste of the fruit or other kind of blessings completely. On the other hand, if a person deserves hell and he goes to hell, then he will feel the punishment 100% as well. Now, if we ponder upon why Allah linked the quality, the clarity of your vision and that you are seeing 100% with the element of iron. What's the link between iron and the clarity of our vision and the power of our vision? Now, in order to understand this, we need to ponder upon our eye and iron. So let's start with our eye. And the one of the basic kind of, or the most important parts of the eye for vision and the clarity of vision is the retina. This one right here. Because the retina contains the photosensitive cells that can sense the outside light, and that's the key process in vision. So if we ponder upon the retina, we see, as I said, it's composed of photosensitive cells. Also, we see that it's supplied with blood, with capillaries, very kind of small diameter, let's say, pipes from an engineering point of view, a very small capillary, supplying the retina with blood. And the reason for this is that Allah God Almighty, also out of His mercy, our tissue is always in a state of regeneration. The old material is taken and the new is placed, such that you would continue operating at 100% efficiency. Now, the supply of blood is key for the regeneration of the tissue. And if you concentrate on the retina, a good supply of blood means that we have always a good retina, and also this implies that we have a good vision. So let's think about from an engineering point of view. We have an engineering challenge here, that these capillaries, they have an inside diameter of about 8 micrometers, meaning 8 over a million of a meter. Very, very small diameter tube. And blood containing red blood cells and elements and plasma and water, all of this, all of this mixture of liquid, it needs to go into this very, very fine tube, let's say. So here comes the role of iron. Now, iron, if we think about it, it's found in our blood as kind of free iron, and also it's linked to RBCs or red blood cells. So let's concentrate on the red blood cells. So in the red blood cells, we have iron atoms or iron particles, iron atoms, as you can see here, represented by the yellow circles. Now, iron is magnetic. And also, so this means that each red blood cell becomes like a tiny magnet, like a small magnet. Now, also the walls of the capillary, these walls right here, they're also magnetized. Also magnetized due to the presence of collagen. So we have two magnetic fields, one produced from the RBCs, red blood cells, and the other produced from the capillaries. As you can see them, the one from the RBCs I represent by these yellow arrows, and the one from the walls by the blue arrows. And as you can see, there is a repulsion between them. Always the magnetic field produced from the RBCs repel the one produced from the walls. This means that this repulsion, magnetic repulsion, does not allow the red blood cells to stick to the walls, and such you have a smoother flow of blood. Again, the iron within the RBCs, it reduces the friction of the blood with the capillary walls. And here we see why Allah linked the clarity of our vision with iron. Iron is key in keeping the flow of blood to the retina smooth. It reduces the friction between the blood and the capillary walls. So you can see the miracle in the Quranic verse where Allah says, "And your vision today is iron," linking the clarity of our vision and the health of our eye with iron. So this is a great discovery from the Quran, the link between iron and the eye and our vision. Now, there is a study, a recent study done in Germany in 2001. Now, doctors there, they looked at some patients who have problems with the retina, and they have occlusion and blocking of the capillaries and vessels supplying the eye. So they tried to look at so many reasons, why is this? And at the end of the study, they found that those patients that are suffering from damage to the retina and dying of certain parts of the retina, that they have mild case of iron deficiency anemia, reduction of the amount of iron in blood, and reduction of the power of blood and the quantity of RBCs, and so iron deficiency anemia. So as you can see, at kind of one a recommendation from the study is that clinicians involved in the management, this is the kind of the recommendation, clinicians involved in the management of chronic iron deficiency anemia should be aware of possible ophthalmic manifestations in this disease. So here we started, like, the scientific study started to link between iron deficiency and problems with vision. So you can see that Allah gives us this great discovery in the Quran, and there started to be like some kind of awareness of this, of the link between iron deficiency and problem with vision and the retina. And as I said, we can understand this from the Quran, that the supply of blood to the microcirculation of the eye, these small capillaries, iron is key in keeping it smooth and steady, in reducing the friction between the blood and the capillary walls. Now, also this great discovery that we learn from the Quran, in just these few words, also can apply to engineering. Now, Allah teaches us that adding iron to a liquid, having it magnetized and having a magnetic walls, will reduce the friction between the liquid and the surrounding walls. So in engineering, people discovered that if they add iron particles to liquids, they call them magnetic liquids, like this one right here, that it reduces the friction between the liquid and the surrounding walls. And in cars, for example, when you change the oil, now there are oils that are called magnetic oils. And one of their great success, that when you add particle to oil, the friction between the oil and the, let's say, the cylinders and the piston and the surrounding cylinder is reduced. And as you can see, it's very similar to what's happening in our eye. The iron in the blood reduces the friction between the blood and the capillaries, making it smoother. smooth flow. So you can see, brothers and sisters, how by pondering upon the Quran, the believer can be a teacher of others. And people hearing this now, if you have problems with your vision and reduced power in your vision, now the answer for your problem, instead of going into trial and error and trying surgery and all of this, can be as simple as looking at the balance of your of iron in your blood and keeping it at the healthy and the optimal ratios. And one quick advice on this is that in previous kind of lectures I talked about a herb that Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him, told us about, the black seed, the Nigellus sativa. This black they call it black cumin sometimes, and this black seed, when I was preparing this lecture, I looked at it because Prophet Muhammad said that it has a cure for every illness except which is poisonous, which is death. So I looked at it, and when you analyze the components found in black seed, you find it contains iron in good amounts and also contains something called folic acid, which is key in maintaining the health of blood and in the synthesis of DNA, meaning like cell processes. So you can take black seed, and this will kind of help to restore the balance of iron in your blood. And this, the problem of your the vision and problems with your vision and clarity and so forth, can be simple as maintaining the iron in your blood at an optimal level. And you see, in the Quranic verse, Allah linked the power of vision and the health of the eye with iron. And to know more details about this topic, please visit my website at www.quran-miracle.com. This is the website. And you can email me at zaidquran@yahoo.com and at gmail.com. And may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon you all.